It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. And in our matchup tonight, we'll see the Boston Celtics going up against the New York Knicks. For New York, playing above 500 in the last few weeks, not bad. They'd like to do better. We'll see if they can add a win tonight. And guys, this team getting some big help in the form of Freak. He has stepped up and been a big contributor over this recent stretch of games. Shaq, what's been the change for him?
You know, he's playing under control, Ernie. He's not trying to do too much with each possession. You know, he's also being more aggressive, taking the initiative. You know, he's just going at people, the barbecue chicken theory, Ernie. Get out of my way. I'm going to eat you.
Yeah, I mean, Freak might be one of my favorite players coming up, Ernie. I mean, his teammates are trusting him more, giving him opportunities, trusting that the fact that he could score, and their success as a unit is also increased because of the trust in him.
You know who Freak reminds me of?
Who's that?
Me.
Oh, yay.
And that wraps it up here. Thanks for joining us. We will see you next time.
And we're here in Boston, Massachusetts. What a gorgeous, beautiful city. Lovely twilight view of downtown Boston. We are live from Boston for an Eastern Conference contest with the Celtics. Great to have you with us, everybody, live on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony and Doris Burke reporting from the sideline. The Knicks will end their road trip here before heading back to New York. They've put it all together over the course of the last seven games. They've only had one loss over that span.
Well, this team is a lot of fun to watch. Everything seems to be going their way, but they're making their own breaks now. They're taking advantage of situations and opportunities, but they're doing everything right at both ends of the floor.
Yeah, and they've been putting on a clinic. I mean, as fun to watch as any other team in the league, and with the calls and bounces that have gone their way, you really get the sense that this is their time.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. And New York, looking at who they've got, Worthy in its shooting guard. Robin Lopez out there with Porzingis, and it's Rivers, and it's Anthony in at the three slot. Thomas goes in, outside Turner, the three. No luck. The Knicks go the other way with it. Coming into this, having notched a win against the Rockets in their last game.
Yeah, the confidence just exuding in that performance on the offensive end. I mean, really illustrates how this team clicks when guys are communicating and executing as a cohesive unit.
Yeah, roadkill is hard to get in this league. I mean, to be a great NBA team, you've got to be able to have that kind of performance on the road. Focused, purposeful, and productive. Really solid. Still can't get anything going here after three tries.
Johnson, the pass to Bradley. It's Bradley on the wing. Six to shoot. He goes up again. And the bucket counts. He's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
Just lazy defense on the glass there.
Well, nobody boxed out. Nobody put a body on anybody else. Things like that not only drive the coach crazy, that stuff gets under my skin.
And he gets it to go.
And you know, it took them a while to get going, but they've finally connected now on their fourth shot of the game.
The Celtics have gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Sullinger the screen. Thomas kicks to Sullinger. Good, and the assist goes to Thomas.
And he came off that screen, and the knee just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him. A good open look, and he splashes home the three.
The Celtics have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Johnson outside. Thomas a screen. Johnson dishes to Sullinger. Near the three-point line, it's Thomas. And again, it's Boston converting.
And that's why it's so important to really be a good screening team. You get a lot of open looks from it.
And Worthy throws it down.
Flush that thing down, young fella.
That is a fierce two-hander.
Maximum force on that dunk.
Rivers against Thomas. Kicks it to Johnson.
Sullinger the screen. Johnson, the pass to Sullinger. Feeds it to Bradley. Releases. And again, it's Boston converted. Knicks trail by three. The drive by Worthy. That one goes. Count it. Worthy's got 6 points.
Carmelo Anthony showing you his passing skill there.
The Celtics have gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 62%. Pass to Sullinger. Outside Bradley. Sullinger the screen. Bradley kicks to Sullinger. Nice ball movement by Boston. It's rebounded by New York. Last time they met in New York.
Yeah, and in their last time playing against this club, they fell short. A lot of cheap fouls really plagued their starting unit.
And you know, Greg, that not only robbed them of some key minutes, but I think it really affected their rhythm and flow in the game. I mean, they'll try to play it more disciplined and safer tonight.
Now, here's Thomas. He had a 33-point outing in their last game against Toronto.
And equally as impressive, the playmaking. Just sensational, the way he was seeing the court and making the game easy for his teammates.
And again, the basket is good from Worthy. Worthy's got 8 points.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Sullinger with the ball. He's coming off a 16-point game against Toronto. Bradley, no one around him. Johnson, no good with the layup. The Knicks with the lead. Anthony dishes to Rivers. Worthy against Bradley. Worthy drawing the double team. Rivers passes to Carmelo. 5 on the clock. Shoots from the block. The rebound by the Celtics. Johnson's got his 3rd rebound on the night. Thomas kicks to Sullinger. It's deflected, and he gets it back. The pass to Johnson. Here's Bradley. Good, and the assist goes to Thomas. Bradley's got 5 now.
A wide open 3. They need much better communication defensively.
Take a look now at some of the most explosive players in the NBA lately. The highest scoring small forwards of the past month. Freak number 1.
There is no doubt he is one of the league's most.
Laverne, he's checked in for Lopez. Derek Williams comes in for Porzingis. Aaron Aflalo, he's checked in for Carmelo Anthony. And it's Tony Roten in for Austin Rivers. New York trailing. Roten dishes to Aflalo. Right side Worthy. He kicks it to Roten. Back to Worthy. 5 to shoot. That shot wide open.
He's yours.
Worthy's got 10.
Really hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter, at least at the offensive end.
Thomas passes to Bradley. And stolen by Aflalo. Right side Worthy. Come on.
takes it from 10. Crowder pulls it in. Boston's gone. 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Worthy with the double team. And Olenek kicks to Thomas. Unloads. Shot by Crowder. No good. Well, it was the Boston Celtics winning their last game against the Raptors.
You know, they played well enough to win, but to be honest with you, I just felt like their opponent's defensive performance was shaky at best.
Yeah, I'd go along with that, Greg. I mean, the game wasn't handed to them, but they definitely didn't have to work as hard for it as they should have.
Here's Thomas, following the basket by Derek Williams. Five on the clock. Here's Bradley. But they get it back. And Olenek kicks to Crowder. Makes no mistake on the open jump shot. Crowder's got it all tied up now for the Celtics. 1:53 left to play in the first quarter. Outside Worthy. Pass to a follow. Pulls from the top of the key. His first shot is a miss. 0-for-1 to start the contest. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
I was able to talk with Brad Stevens for a minute. After taking the first matchup with them, he wants his team to be even more assertive on the offensive end. He told me, "I feel we can have our way on offense. Get them into matchups that they don't like and find points that way. It's what helped in our first meeting. Let's see if they can do it again here, guys."
Okay, Doris, well, the offensive approach, a primary force in the game plan today, guys.
Yeah, they are out to put up a big number today, and I think they can do it.
Well, that certainly seems to be the goal. I mean, it could be a shootout if their plans come to fruition. Here, Kevin, we can get a look at New York and what kind of numbers they've put up these last 10 games. First in field goal percentage, first in fewest turnovers a game, and they're number one in opponent scoring. They don't allow teams to get into a rhythm offensively, and thus they're able to hold those points down.
You said it all right there, the hottest shooting team in the league. And that tells you not only are they shooting it well, but they're also focused on creating terrific opportunities for one another.
Now, here's Bradley. An 11-point game for him in the win against Toronto. In the corner, Crowder with it, and it's blocked by Worthy.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
It always is, and it has been so far, and they've gotten a nice edge on the glass.
Three consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. The defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Guys, they are getting exposed in terms of their low post defense.
Bradley dishes to Thomas. Outside Bradley. Six on the shot clock. Boston needs to get off a shot. The shot no good. Worthy with the defensive effort. The Knicks leading by 4. Got a piece of it. Crowder with the steal. Here's Thomas. And we know he can score. He's averaging around 21.5 points a game. Roten, the pass to Worthy. From deep. Got it! He got it!
Just in time!
What a shot!
Wow, what a miracle heave to finish off the quarter. How'd he get that one to go?
I don't know, but I think that's a 2% shot. He'd make 2 out of 100 of those if you gave them to him.
And some tough time for the Knicks, but you listen to Carmelo Anthony, it's clear he's invested in this franchise. Knicks fans rooting for Carmelo to help make New York a playoff venue once again.
And you know what? It's going to take a lot more than Carmelo playing strong to get the Knicks back into the playoffs and to make them a destination to where NBA stars want to come.
And we welcome you back to more NBA action. Players looking hydrated and plenty of Gatorade to help them get their job done tonight. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Knicks.
Boy, they've come out of that locker room with a hot hand. Those jumpers have been falling for them.
And also, how about the willingness to attack the basket and challenge the defense here tonight?
Amir Johnson is out there with Tyler Zeller. Then it's Jay Crowder. Then it's Isaiah Thomas. And it's Turner in at the point guard position. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Celtics. That one's in there. The Knicks lead is cut to just 5 points on the basket from Johnson.
In that height, with that much of an advantage height-wise, there's just not a lot the defense can do.
It's Worthy missing. Well, the Celtics shooting poorly, just 35% so far. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Finish off the break. Worthy's got the lead up to 7 now for the Knicks.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on the clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
Here's Zeller following the basket by Freak. Now here's Zeller. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Thomas gets an open look. That one falls, coming off the Johnson feet.
You cannot leave him alone like that, especially from long range.
Worthy kicks to Rivers. Worthy drawing the double team. Got him up in the air with the pump fake and then took advantage. Worthy's got 4 points this quarter.
They're spraying them home from mid-range today, guys.
Finding the gaps in the defense and really just slicing and dicing them right now.
There's the bucket. Good.
And that's a nice possession. Did a good job to get that open shot.
Here we go, Boston. Now coming to the court are your Celtics Panthers. Give it up.
Been more than solid over the last month. He's around 10 points per game, 5 rebounds, and 3 assists.
The Knicks making a switch here. Porzingis has checked in. And so it's New York with it. 4-point game. Next up on the docket, the Bucks following this one. That game is the first and last of their homestand.
No slowing him down. Just some incredible numbers for Houdini. He's got 19 points. And a couple of nice steals, too. He's gotten after it on the boards for them as well as in the transition game.
And I like the fact that one has really fed into the other.
It's his first trip to the line.
He's been doing really nice work at the line. 83%.
Yeah, guys. I mean, he's been a very steady hand for them when it comes to his free throw shooting.
That's also good, so he hits both free throws.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Rockets got the job done. He had 37 points and seemed to have a hand in every defensive stop. Good numbers for him in both the steals and blocks columns. It was a performance for the ages and one that will have the whole league talking.
Great, Doris. Thanks. Any chance we see him top that performance right here tonight?
You know, I can't imagine he'd be able to pull off that kind of an outing two games in a row. But, hey, that's what the truly great ones are capable of doing.
Boy, even if he came close to matching it, that would be really impressive. But I tell you, that's asking an awful lot of one guy. Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had early.
And the shot's good from Crowder.
Pretty, pretty passing. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Worthy drawing the double team. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Six to shoot. Dishes it to Rivers. From deep three-point range. Can't get it to go. And the Celtics going the other way now. Turner passes to Thomas. And Turner kicks to Crowder. That's tipped. And a fast break now for the Knicks. Always going up for the alley-oop here. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Rivers has got the lead up to 8 now for the Knicks. Rivers against Turner to the paint. Looks for Thomas. Gets it to him. And again, it's Boston converting.
Still trailing, but their offense is off life support here in the second quarter. It's got a pulse.
Good point, Clark. They're starting to make some shots, looking to try and get back in this one.
Now here's Worthy. 37 points in the win against the Rockets in Houston.
And don't forget about his work on the glass. I mean, he contributed in a number of ways.
For New York, they have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
Yeah, guys, they can feel very good about themselves when you bring up those statistics. Impressive numbers.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Jared Sullinger's checked in for Tyler Zeller, for Amir Johnson. And Bradley's subbed in for Isaiah Thomas. And New York with a change here, too. Green's checked in. And both free throws good for Lopez.
Well, as far as the league's big men go, he's one of the very best at the foul line.
Turner dishes to Sullinger. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. Levert, he's checked in for the Knicks. For Boston, they have shot just one free throw, missing that one early.
Yeah, pretty good numbers on the season when you look at their free throw attempts, right around 78%.
Guys, that says a lot about the poise of this team. I mean, they've been so calm, cool, and consistent at the stripe this year. I mean, that's impressive.
And he floats in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening.
It really is, Clark. The defenders need to do a better job of closing those lanes to the hoop.
Here's Rivers. After Jared Sullinger's bucket, Porzingis passes to Worthy. Outside, Green. From outside, off the mark. Celtics trail by 5. Outside, Turner. The feed to Bradley. Worthy pulls it in. Worthy's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Worthy drawing the double team. Shot's good by Laverne. Laverne's got 4 points in the quarter.
That's leadership. Really, really valuable to have someone who can just take charge like he has.
Well, there's a certain amount of confidence you have when the ball is in his hands at that end of the floor right now. I mean, he just gives you a sense of calm and confidence because of how good he is.
Now here's Worthy. Pulling the miss by Avery Bradley. Outside Worthy. There's a good screen. Just 5 on the clock. Laverne, there's the basket and make it a double-digit lead. Laverne's got his third bucket of the night. The Celtics have gone 7 of 11 from the field in the second quarter.
He's been dominant over the last month. First in scoring, first in steals, and how about him?
The Celtics making a switch here. Olynyk's checked in. And then for New York, Williams, he's checked in for Porzingis. And Roten subbed in for Rivers. Here's Bradley. He's got 5. Pass to Mickey. A stupendous finish in traffic. Mickey's got his first points of the night.
Well, they really started to come on here in the second.
Clark, it's about how much more focused they look offensively here. They're trying to make up some ground. Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
Now here's Zellinger. He's got 7, and that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. Here's Bradley.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
Roten kicks it over to Worthy. He feeds it to Roten. Right side Worthy. Clock at 6. Trying his luck deep. Rebound by Olynyk. Celtics trail by 10. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, you know, exploding to the basket like that, Greg, just as soon as that ball was going the other way, that's exactly how you want to do it.
Worthy dishes to Laverne. Misses the hole, and he's now 3 for 4. The Celtics shooting very well, 56% from the floor here in the second quarter. Poke loose and stolen by Roten. And the dunk by Worthy.
And guys got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
That's exactly the way to do it too, Kevin. Go hard to the bucket and don't let them set up the defense.
Now here's Olynyk. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Out to Turner, down to 5 on the shot clock. Turner missing again. The Knicks leading by 10. Outside Worthy. Passes it to Roten. He dishes it to Laverne. Worthy kicks to Roten. Knocks down the 3-ball. Roten's got 5 now. 17 seconds left in the first half of the game. Pass to Mickey. There's the dish to Olynyk. And the foul called on Freak. That's his first foul.
That's his first personal foul. Substitution on the court.
5 seconds left here in the second. Up off the screen. And the dunk by Olynyk.
Tell you what, Kevin, they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
Clark, that deficit will go away quickly if he does.
And how about how he capped that one out, almost like the 1-2 punch.
And that concludes the first half. Knicks lead by 11. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, what a great job you did, both moving the ball and passing it and scoring it. What has been the key for you to this point?
I don't really think there's been a key. I mean, that's what you're supposed to do on a basketball court, right? I guess the one other thing is rebound, so I'll try to focus on that for next time.
Good luck with that, young man. Kevin, a young talent looking to do whatever it takes to make it in the NBA.
Thank you for the great interview, Doris. We'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
Okay, that was some strong work in the first half. Let's talk about what we got to do to keep this crowd out of the game. Well, we've established a clear dominance on the interior at the offensive end. And until they prove they can stop our inside game, we have to continue to pound it into the post. Something we're doing well right now is spacing and shot selection. And we're shooting it pretty well. Getting open, getting looks, and making sure to make the pass when you don't see something. And let me touch on tempo for a second. We're not out to use the whole shot clock, but I would like to see us get set up offensively. All right, we're in good shape, but this is a strong team we're up against. We're going to have to weather some storms in the second half. Come on, fellas, we got this.
Well, we're getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. Celtics trail by 11. On the court for the Knicks, Worthy, he's in at shooting guard. Porzingis is out there with Robin Lopez. Then it's Anthony, and it's Rivers in at the point guard.
Nice move and finish. I think the halftime break really gave him a second win.
Here's Rivers. After Jared Sullinger's bucket, Worthy drawing the double team. Anthony, the pass to Worthy. It's stolen by Bradley. And here we go. Thomas heading to the hoop. Rejected by Worthy. And here's Rivers.
Move the ball.
Wide open. And that one's good.
Austin Rivers.
Rivers has got his second basket. Boston shooting from the field. 44%, not bad. Thomas kicks to Johnson. Outside Thomas. To the middle. Good on that shot. With that, the Knick lead is cut down now to just 9 in the basket from Johnson.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
And how? I mean, they're taking this defense to task, taking them to school. Every one of their last 10 points have come in the paint.
And it's good. Walk through contact, hits the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not supposed to be easy down there, and a little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
The Celtics shooting their third free throw shot of the game. The Knicks leading by 6. To the inside, here's Worthy. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
I tell you what, he can do a lot more damage to that rim than that when he wants to.
And you know, Clark, with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Me too.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm glad he didn't, because otherwise we'd probably have a 45-minute delay here if he shattered the backboard.
Kicks it to Rivers. Worthy with it. Sullinger picks him up. Worthy, no good. The Celtics have gone 3-5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. And the foul called on Freak. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Yeah, and as quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge.
Jay Crowder's checked in for Evan Turner. And Sullinger kicks to Thomas. Johnson the screen. Thomas against Rivers. Shot clock at 5. Thomas dishes to Sullinger. And Sullinger missing.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
Feeds it to Anthony. Outside Worthy. Releases from 15. Lopez sinks that one from the post. And now a 10-point Knicks lead.
I love the killer instinct he shows right there, exploding to the rim to add to the lead.
Doris from the sideline. And a whole new group out on the floor right now for the Knicks. Celtics trail by 4. Turner with it. Now guarded by Aflalo. And it's out of bounds. The Knicks will take it the other way.
I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
New York's gone 1-4 in 3-point shots here in the third. Outside Worthy. Not loose. Double team on Thomas. The pass to Turner. Olynyk sets a screen for Turner. He kicks to Olynyk. 4 on the shot clock. Thomas outside. It's deflected, and they force the shot clock violation. Great D. .102 left in the third quarter.
All right, well, look at how the hustle game has been going for the Knicks.
We've seen them make the extra effort from a defensive standpoint, closing out airspace and sending shots back.
Another factor here tonight has been the amount of points they've scored off turnovers.
Celtics trail by six. Pass to Olynyk. Celtics passing it around. Shot to stop the drought. Again, Thomas missing.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
Here's Worthy. That's good. Worthy's got 29. Boston's gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. We've got a nine-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Turner passes to Crowder from the arc, and he gets it to go. Crowder's got 6 points in the quarter.
With the success they've been having from the three-point line since halftime, I'll bet you that scoreboard starts to look a lot different real soon.
Partner, that's assuming they can continue that hot shooting. But if they do, and especially if they can get a few stops, you have to think they'll make this thing interesting.
With 2 seconds left, that's good. And it's Thomas picking up the assist. Thomas got assist number 8 now on the night. And that's going to do it for the third quarter. It's the Knicks. They're up by... And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. Bradley and Turner filling out the perimeter. Tyler Zeller out there with Kelly Olynyk, and it's Thomas in at the point. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. Now here's Aflalo. Passes it to Porzingis. Down low, Turner with the steal. Now Zeller wants to get it to Turner and does.
I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
Shooting for Boston. Evan Turner. We'll be at the line shooting two.
All right now, gentlemen. Two shots. Loose shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
Yeah, I like that they haven't lost their aggressiveness here in the second, despite being down.
That's exactly when you need to be aggressive, Greg. You know that. I mean, another good job, though, of drawing contact and getting to the free throw line.
Johnson, he's checked in for Boston. The Knicks also changing it up. Robin Lopez is checked in for Laverne. Anthony comes in for Aaron Aflalo. And it's Austin Rivers in for Roten.
Listen, they're still right in this thing. Missing that free throw, though, keeps this a two-possession deficit.
Anthony kicks it over to Worthy. Here's Lopez, laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Well, the defensive rotations, Greg, have been a step slow, and it's really helped them get that ball inside time after time.
Thomas gets the bucket.
You know, a huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control is essential in that situation. I mean, if you're giving up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
Jared Sullinger's checked in for Boston. Fourth quarter, still young, just over a minute play. Thomas with the ball. Outside Brantley. Out to Turner. All sorts of time, and it's Boston with another.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
New York's gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight. 5 of 12. It's stolen by Brantley. Inside, Johnson can't tie it up as that one misses. The Knicks with the lead. Here's Anthony. And it's Brantley with the rebound. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. The shot by Turner, no good. And for the Knicks, they're shooting one of the high points for them in this game at 54%. Worthy dishes to Lopez. Bradley against Worthy. The feed to Rivers. He's looking for Lopez and finds him. Five on the clock. Worthy, the pass to Porzingis. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires.
Yes, sir.
And the Knicks lead by four.
Just such a good shooter from that range.
And you factor in his height advantage, it's almost unfair.
Bradley kicks to Turner. Sullinger against Lopez. Sullinger outside. Johnson, that's for two. That's tipped. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation.
New York calls timeout.
We got to be more physical on defense. They are getting to the middle of the floor way too easy. Get into them on the perimeter. Posts. Rotate over and make your presence felt. Quit being so soft.
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Anthony dishes to Worthy. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Boy, he's just dangling from the rim after sending it through there.
You can see which team now has the swagger, Clark, right now.
Yeah, it's exactly. It's with them.
Okay, guys, that's what... And he takes it right at the man who just scored on him.
That's the way to answer back with an in-your-face stuff.
Guys, some pride bubbling up right there. He wasn't about to be outshone.
That was a nice free play brought to you by Kia. Sinks it, and the shot from Porzingis.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Thomas against Rivers. Floats one. It's deflected. Dishes it to Worthy. Stolen by Thomas. They get a hand on it. And stolen by Worthy. Ahead. He feeds it to Lopez. Shot's good. And now an 8-point Knicks lead.
And you're not going to pass up that kind of play.
Thomas passes to Brent. Wasted no time on that shot, but it's off the mark. For New York, they've gone 5 of 6 from the field to start the fourth quarter on a roll. Worthy with the bucket.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
And that's keyed this run. Passing it with purpose. The D hasn't been able to keep up.
Sullinger the screen. Here's Thomas. Pocket six. Sullinger the screen. Takes the 13-footer and off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. 19 points for Isaiah Thomas. The drive by Worthy. Worthy drawing the double team. Anthony with the bucket.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting in the paint and keep scoring points. Keep it going.
Not a lot you can do as a defense when they keep getting the ball in the paint like this.
Thomas against Rivers. Thomas kicks to Johnson. It's tipped. They get it back. Really left alone that team. 16 points for Avery Bradley.
That gives him his second three of the half with three total for the game.
That's good from Worthy on the assist by Rivers. That's 36 points for Freak.
First three of the half, second of the game. Can he heat up?
Outside Thomas. High arcing shot. The Knicks leading by 10. Outside Worthy.
Move the ball.
From deep. Bradley with some nice D. Boston's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Thomas with the ball. Picked up by Rivers. Sullinger dishes to Turner. A second chance effort and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Well, Jared Sullinger's been getting it done. 9 points and a block.
At the line for the Celtics, Jared Sullinger will be at the line shooting two.
Shooting two. Shooting two.
He misses the free throw. Crowder, he's checked in for Evan Turner. And he sinks the second. The Knicks leading by 9. Now here's Rivers. Outside Worthy. He dishes it to Lopez. Got a hand on it. Well, for the Celtics, this one not looking good. And stolen by Worthy. And a fast break now for New York. Anthony leading the charge. From deep. Rebound Boston. Sullinger's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Rivers against Thomas. Sullinger the screen. And the basket by Johnson.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
Down low. It's tipped. To the paint. Here's Thomas. And it's blocked. And they'll keep possession.
That'll be Boston as it goes out of bounds. Celtics retain possession. Some information for us, Doris.
Hey, guys. Well, Brad Stevens had some advice for the team over that last break. We can't let up now. If we stay and make a few plays, we'll be right back in it. His message was clear. Stay the course, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. Celtics trail by 7. Double team on Thomas. Shot clock at 6. And that one's good, Anthony. Anthony's got 4 points this quarter.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
Just no resistance on the interior.
Thomas against Rivers. Thomas passes to Sellinger. Breaks a big height, comes and goes in. And here is Anthony. The dish to Worthy. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. Worthy's got 38 points.
This is a serious game-clenching run they're on.
Yeah, I agree with you. Just not backing off here. I mean, they're looking to close this one out in style. What a time to have this kind of surge.
And that one's good, Anthony.
And really, no better feeling than to go on the road and play this well and get the win.
Yeah, it's always a good win when you play the kind of game they have played tonight. I mean, especially, though, when you get it done on the road. That's a special, special feeling there.
No good from the wing. And Boston has possession. They trail by 11. And Thomas, here we go. An easy 2 points on the layup.
No doubt about it. He has done a ton to help his team, but he's going to have to do even more if they want to have a chance to get back in this.
Here's Worthy. No good. So it's New York.
Well, once again, you filled the box score up. Yet another triple-double. How many more are we going to see this year?
I really don't know.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Thank you, Kevin. And now we have the opportunity to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Freak. Just a monster first quarter of the game. He came out hot and just never cooled down. That boost he gave his team early on, a huge factor.
Seeing Freak dominate the way he did tonight reminded me of watching him play in high school. He was a man among boys. He was a four-time consensus All-American back then. Overall, great game.
He was up to every single challenge he faced tonight. He was in such control of the ball game. His showcase of his skill set was awesome.
And that brings us to the end of our broadcast for this evening. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson saying good night, and we'll see you again soon, but not soon enough.